Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. This is Rusty 78609. I'm out here traveling in my Class C motorhome, my 2021 Thar 4 Winds 22E, 24-foot long Class C motorhome on a Chevy chassis, 6-liter Chevy. I get 10 miles to the gallon. Right now I'm getting 10.1, towing a 35-pound Chevy Bolt EV, electric vehicle. And let's talk about that a little bit. Why? Well, because I want to. And what we got is, I thought about, I've got a home base in Capitan, New Mexico, and I've got a home base in Texas at Fort Clark Springs, 500 miles apart. One's for the summer, one's for the winter. And then the rest of the world is in between. But what I want to say is, I thought about getting, putting a house or something on the place in Capitan. I have a little tiny home in Texas with an RV cover, and I thought, well, just sell the RV and put a place in Capitan and just drive a car back and forth. Well, let me tell you what, there is nothing better than the convenience of a motorhome. I guarantee you. I've had travel trailers, fifth wheels, everything you could have. I've been full-timing for a long time, and what I have found is, like just now, I pulled over and changed clothes in my house here, my Class C motorhome. You can't do that in a car. You could. But be realistic. It ain't something you want to do. And if you got to pee or whatever, you got a restroom here in this RV that you don't have in a car, right? Right. So, guys, the convenience of a motorhome as compared to towing an RV, the differences are dramatic. Now, again, now cost can be a factor. When I bought my Class C motorhome, I picked it up December the 9th, 2020, and it cost me a total of $65,000, including all taxes and fees from Motorhome Specialists in El Dorado, Texas. And they have the best deals of anybody in the whole United States, as far as I can tell. They are the largest motorhome dealer in the United States by volume, I believe. But having said that, the convenience of traveling in a motorhome as compared to a travel trailer or dragging a fifth wheel, the differences are amazing. I mean, it's just so nice. I mean, not only that, you got a beautiful view out this big windshield here. you can, if there was somebody with you, which there's not, I'm by myself. I have my dog, Romeo, and that's it. Just, me and the dog, And so, yeah, but if you had a wife or whatever, she could get up, go fix a sandwich. You had to be careful, don't fall down, all that crap, but you could. And as far as towing a vehicle, easy peasy. Get you a tow dolly. You can tow a front-wheel drive car on a tow dolly. You cannot tow an all-wheel car on a tow dolly, or you gotta get put it on a carrier. but no, it's just so nice to be able to enjoy, and if you want to pull over and fix you a sandwich, you don't even have to get out. There's a little safety factor in that, I guess. If you pull into a roadside rest area or whatever, you don't have to get out. You're self-contained. If you want to run the air conditioner, you can. I got a 4,000 watt Onan generator, runs everything in the whole RV. And I hope the sound's doing okay on this thing. I'm driving down the highway, and I don't have any kind of external speaker thing or mic. This area of Texas that I'm in now, near Big Lake, Texas, this is kind of oil well country here, or oil country. We're not too far from Odessa, Midland, and stuff, so there's a lot of oil field traffic on this road. But this is the least traveled road I can find going north to get to where I want to go. But again, Class C motorhome, man, it just occurred to me, there's no sense for me to build a place in Capitan. I'll just continue doing what I'm doing, living in the motorhome when I'm there, because I can live in the motorhome on my lot in Capitan with all utilities. Basically, it hardly costs anything. And I like living in the motorhome. I'm RV institutionalized. I've learned to enjoy living in a small space, and I intend to keep that up. So, for those of you that are looking for a motorhome, or not motorhomes, but thinking about the RV way of life, if you have the money, now I know that motorhomes, the Class C's, the Class B's have gone crazy. I don't know what they're thinking about there. You get half the space for twice the price. I never figured that out. Well, you get a little bit better fuel economy, but you're not driving all the time. You know, with a Class C motorhome, you tow a vehicle that's very economical. When you get to your destination, wherever it is, or your destinations, then you just hop in your little 30-mile-per-gallon car and go zipping around. In my case, I've got an electric vehicle. It costs me about 3.5 cents a mile to drive it and charge it. And if I'm in a state park or a national park or whatever, and they've got electric, I'll just charge it there. It won't even be 3.5 cents. So having said that, guys, from on the road again with Romeo, this is Rusty 78609 saying, stay Class C or go Class C. Be classy, okay? Anyway, guys, thumbs up. Carpe diem. Adios. Bye-bye. Buy anything you want anytime. Use the Amazon link if you choose to. Doesn't cost you a penny. Drink plenty of water. Stretch. Walk, exercise, do all that stuff. Stand guard at the door of your mind. Most important, guys. Give your brain something positive to work with. Anyway, guys, with that in mind, enjoy your life. Enjoy your day. Adios. Isn't that a beautiful blue sky? It sure is. Adios.